Judy Franco here. Welcome to the show. We're pleased as punch to have you with us today. We had talked about this situation off the air on Friday. We decided that after really, really blowing up on the weekend shows, we said, how can we not discuss it today? That's because that's what everybody's talking about, and that is the unfortunate, deliberate, what appears to be a deliberate crash of the Germanwings airplane
into the Alps. Yeah, they came up with that conclusion fairly quickly as they recovered the black box in a very remote area. And all the things we had to worry about before, weather, mechanical difficulties, terrorism, security, you got that all buttoned down. All kinds of regulations, the cockpit's got to be secure. That was an unintended consequence in this case, that now that you've made the cockpit impenetrable, that the pilot, who was the only one on board that could have saved the plane from going down, was not able to get back in. So we thought we'd ask you, does it make you nervous now?
Or were you always nervous and now you've sworn off flying? 1-800-283-101.5 is our phone number. Also, we're going to talk to an aviation expert later on, an aviation medical examiner, who's going to give us a little insight. She's a person who evaluates and determines pilots' fitness to fly when they have different issues. So we look forward to that.
Yeah, I think she's on the line. Dr. Brunetti, Jacqueline Brunetti, she's an aviation medical examiner at Holy Name Medical Center in Teaneck for over 20 years and is certified by the FAA to evaluate and determine fitness to fly for pilots with substance abuse and also depression.
I have a million questions for her, but let me give the phone number, Dennis, so our listeners can also call in and tell us what their feeling is in general about flying, and has it changed since this tragedy? 1-800-283-101.5 is our phone number.
When you board the plane, you try to take a look at the pilot. Normally, you see the flight attendants, welcome, welcome, welcome. I love that feeling because you're usually going on vacation, you know, or something.
Right.
Just a special feeling you only get, you know, a few times in your year, if you're lucky, or in your lifetime.
Right.
And I like that. Like, just kind of peer into the cockpit and see.
Lately, though, the pilot is standing there as well, so you can see his face. Have you noticed that? Last few flights I've taken, pilot was standing there too. Maybe not the co-captain, but one guy standing there looking official.
Well, I complained one time because the pilot had a wee-wee toy. And I said, okay.
And that offended you.
No, I don't mind him pumping my gas at Wawa, but
the red nose is over the top. Okay.
All right, let's talk to Dr. Brunetti, who is on the line, who screens a lot of the pilots.
Dr. Jacqueline Brunetti, welcome to the program. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, good morning, Dennis and Judy.
Hey, great to have you here.
Great.
All right, gotta ask you.
Some amazing things going on, it seems.
Yeah, the first question off the top of my head, I just have to get this out, okay? And I thought about this morning. Dennis and I talked about it. Should a psychiatrist who might hear that somebody has mental issues, whether it's anxiety or any mental should a psychiatrist then go to his company and say, hey, this guy's in charge of a lot of people. I got to tell you this. Or is patient privacy in effect there?
All right. Well, apparently we're talking about a German airline, and it seems that, or at least what I have learned in the last few days, that the privacy laws in Germany are different from the privacy laws in the United States. And
right.
Although we have some stringent patient confidentiality laws, which actually all evolved in the early HIV era to protect information, there is the ability to report to the appropriate agency if there is an issue of greater injury that may happen as a result of something that's picked up in an exam.
Okay, so I just want to know that if somebody goes to their psychiatrist and says, I'm a pilot and I might kill a bunch of people, please tell me that somebody can warn the airline of that.
Absolutely. In that okay. particular situation, yes. And I think you would be, you are bound to do something like that. Now, on the other hand, we live in the United States where there are probably more lawyers than doctors per, I don't know,
per capita.
What the multiple is there. But, you know, you have to be very careful in doing this and going to the appropriate place and the appropriate person. And but yes, no, there is a provision in the HIPAA law, which is the regulation which covers all this, to report without consent information that may in the downstream have. You know, look, we do this for patient, little kids in the emergency room,
right,
who you think have been battered. Or battered adults.
Right, and now we're talking. Yeah, now we're talking of thousands of people or hundreds of people's lives. Now we know that the cockpit standards are different with the EU than the US because they don't require that two people are in the cockpit like we may have here.
Well, they do now, apparently in Germany.
Right, but and it's the entire European Union has one standard. Do they have different psych standards there that we do here that we might feel more comfortable knowing our pilots are more scrutinized?
Well, I'm familiar with our standards, obviously, and the Canadian standards because I can do the Canadian exams also. I really don't know if there is that much difference in the European agencies, but the airlines themselves have psychological testing,
right,
when the hot pilots are being employed. And, you know, during these guys are seen, or the commercial pilots are seen every 6 months. And, you know, part of our exam, our aviation exam, is you know, talking to the patient or talking to the airman and, you know, assessing.
Is there a different standard between
overall, you know, intactness, let's say.
Yeah.
You know, the degree, however, to which that's done, I'm not sure. I go into it quite deeply because I also have a background in integrative medicine. And I tend to ask those questions. There is, if I can give the listeners a website,
yeah,
it's www.asma, that's A as in Alpha, S Sierra, M Mike, A Alpha, .org. It's the Aerospace Medical Association. They actually addressed this issue in 2014. They go to the website, go to publications, and then drop-down menu says Pilot Mental Health. There's some very good information there and some recommendations,
great,
as to what we should be changing and maybe tightening up. We may need a grassroots push on this because, you know, as you know, it takes a lot to change something.
In your expert opinion, can we do more and should we do more?
My knee-jerk response in the beginning of learning this is like, you know, we're doing all of what we're supposed to be doing. But the reality is the society is changing.
Yep.
And this is not the first guy to do this, Dr. Brunetti. I mean, I know Egypt Air, when we were on the air together, Dennis, in 2000, I don't know the date, 1999 maybe, the guy, there was an Egypt airplane that did the same thing. Yeah. And from what I hear, there are 16, 17 other flights throughout history where a pilot took a plane down.
Right. But keep in mind, there are 30 million departures a year. So this is the outlier. These are the very, you know, less than, you know, half of a percent of what you're looking at. But as I said, the culture is changing. The society is changing. Things are not like the old John Wayne days that, you know, people are straight as arrows. And so I think you have to keep that in mind, you know, as you look,
right,
at,
and not get paranoid.
Look at recommendations and how people are screened. For the most part, and I want the listeners to know, flying is safe. It's probably safer than driving on Route 80, which I do every day.
It statistically is one of the safest things we do in our daily lives as far as travel. Dr. Brunetti, thank you so much for your expertise. Appreciate your calling in today.
Have a good day, Dennis Judy.
Thank you so much. We appreciate it. Dr. Jacqueline Brunetti, an aviation medical examiner at Holy Name Medical Center in Teaneck, New Jersey. We thank her for her time.